Hello everybody, this is Mr. Van Zura. This video is for middle school students and we'll cover our band lab project checklist and rubric. So over the last couple weeks, I've had you introduce yourselves to band lab by creating an account and then starting a small mini project just where you got the hang of putting some loops into your track, trying some different instruments. And this week we're going to do our first formal project on band lab. It's a very easy project and this checklist will cover all the things that you need to include. I'm hoping that everyone is accustomed to BandLab by now, but if you have any questions at any point during this week, feel free to email me or to set up a time to have a virtual meet where I can help you answer any questions that you have. So for this project, you just need to make sure it includes a couple of things. First, you need to make sure that your song or your project has each of the following instruments. You should have a bass part, a guitar part, a drums or percussion part, and a keyboard or piano part. I will grade based on the fact that you have all four instruments. You need to have all four of these in your project. If you have three out of the four, you will be marked down for that. So just make sure that you have all four of them in your project. They don't all need to be happening the entire time, meaning that for the entire song, you don't need to have bass, guitar, drums, and keyboard all playing. You could have one instrument start, then bring in another one and pass it off. Or you could have three of them playing and then there's a solo for another in the middle. It's whatever you want. Just as long as all four of these instruments appear somewhere in your project. Second guideline is that you need to make sure that your song is at least 1 minute in length. When you play your project, you'll see a time running as you listen to it. Just make sure that time hits 1 minute by the end. That should also roughly be about 40 measures or so within BandLab, but again, you could just check the time by hitting play. It shouldn't take you that long to get a minute's long worth of music. Number three and number four are super easy. Number three is that you just need to make sure that your project has a title. And to do that, if you remember, you can check the tutorial, but you go to the top where it says new project and just change it to a new title. And last but not least, you need to make sure you share your project with Mr. Van Zura. Again, there are directions of how to do that on the website or in the tutorial video, but just make sure that when your project is done, you share it with me so I can see it and make sure that you followed all the guidelines. That's our checklist. You'll see next to each point, there is a little line that you can, if you print this out at home, you can check each one that you do. So once I put my bass, I can check, then guitar, drums, keyboard, and I can go through and check off and make sure I follow all of these. If you are able to check off every single one of these points, I promise you, you will get an A for this project. So all you need to do is make sure that all of these things are present. With that in mind, this is what your rubric looks like for this project. There are four categories. Each of those were the things we just talked about. So number one being the instrumentation, making sure all four of those instruments are in your piece. Number two is time, making sure that's at least 1 minute long. The title, just naming it something. And that you shared it with Mr. Van Zura. This rubric is very simple. It's either you did it, you did complete the objective, or you did not. It was incomplete. So for instrumentation, if you had all four required instruments in your project, you get a 40 out of 40. If your project is at least 1 minute long, you get a 40 out of 40. If your project has a title, you get 10 out of 10. And if your project is shared with Mr. Van Zura, you also get 10 out of 10. So all you're doing to complete this assignment is checking off each of these boxes, making sure it's complete, and you'll get 100 pretty easily. It's not a sense of how good or how well you put your project together for this project. All it is just seeing that you know how to follow the directions and making sure that you understand BandLab so you can very easily get all these complete and very easily get 100 on your project. At the bottom of your rubric, I'll be able to write comments for you. So either if you miss one of these things, I'll write you a comment for that. Or if I have pointers or want to congratulate you or say something sounds really good, I'll put that in the comments as well. But that covers our rubric. That's all the things you need to consider when doing your project. And again, it's super easy to pass this and get 100 on this project because all you need to do is just make sure that all four of these goals are met and completed. That covers our BandLab project. As always, if you have any questions, please just email me or put a question you have on the website and I'll be happy to get back to you. Have fun composing on BandLab this week. I'll see some of you in class and I look forward to hearing all of your projects.